Hi everyone, in this video I just want to walk you through the general reactor design process that we must go through when designing a reactor. Since this is only the second video in our chemical reaction engineering course, do not worry too much about the minor details yet. This video is just meant to give you a broad understanding of why we're going to be learning certain things throughout this course. Alright, so let's get into it. The first thing you need to know when designing a reactor is how much product you need and what concentration is acceptable. The concentration necessary will typically be set by industry standard or by whoever is purchasing your final product. Then you need to begin looking at what reactions can give you your final product. Typically, this will require quite a bit of research, as typically there are many different ways to reach a final product. However, ideally, you want the most direct or the cheapest to produce, and in looking at this, examine different potential reaction pathways. It is important to understand the operating conditions necessary for each reaction, so the temperature and pressures that are needed to force each reaction. Then you should examine the reaction kinetics. So think of things like if a catalyst is necessary, or does a component need to be in the vapor phase to react, things like that. Now that we have an understanding about what our reaction looks like and the conditions it needs, we can begin to design the actual reactor. This is done through completing energy and mass balances, examining the single pass conversion, so how much of your reactants actually converted to the product upon one pass through your reactor, and the size of our reactor, things like that. Things like this can typically be completed through programs like Aspen HYSYS for more complex reactions. Then you can move on to the concluding steps, such as ensuring that there are no environmental concerns with your design, designing your pumps, heat exchangers, purification steps, and anything else you may need that is necessary. Also, you perform an economic analysis to ensure that your process is feasible and realistic. Unfortunately, at this point, your work is not simply done. Although your reactor could be completely feasible at this first iteration, it is important to recognize that proper reactor design is accomplished through many iterations. So, we keep improving upon what we know works and find ways to save our company money, or make our reactor more safe, or more environmentally friendly, etc. This could be through examining more efficient reaction pathways, selecting catalysts that are better for a certain application, and a million other things. As we work our way through this course, we will examine practice problems and discuss in detail how we go about making proper design decisions for certain reactors, so stay tuned for that. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of the general reactor design process that we will use throughout this course. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best.